My name is Auntie Mary. I hope you are good and I hope you are staying safe. It is another Sunday and we are going to worship God. Now, before we worship God, before we praise Him, I want us to close our eyes for prayers. So put your hands together and close your eyes. In Jesus' name, in the mighty name of Jesus, Father, we thank you for today. We thank you for all you have done for us. We thank you for your guidance and your protection. Father, we say let your name be glorified in Jesus' name. As we go into your word and worship you today, Father, let your name be glorified in Jesus' name. Touch our lives, heal us, save us, and deliver us from all evil in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father, Lord, for answered prayers. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Amen. Now, it's time to worship God. It's time to give.
Jesus is strong. Jesus is wiser. Jesus is richer. Jesus is greater.
To separated. We are far from Him. Yes, we need a Savior. God has sent His Son. Jesus came to save sinners like you and me, dying on the cross to set us free. Save sinners like you and me, rose from the dead, He beats it.
Sing, you are God, Father. Good morning. How are you doing? It's another beautiful Sunday, and I'm so happy to welcome you to church. My name is Auntie Adeze, and together we are going to have fun. Now, our topic for today is taken from Lesson 5 of Zeal, and the topic is, why did Jesus come to the world? Why did Jesus come to the world? Our memory verse is taken from Matthew chapter 1, verse 21. Matthew chapter 1, verse 21. And it says, and she will bring forth a son, and you shall call his name Jesus, for he will save his people from their sins. Let's take that again. Matthew chapter 1, verse 21, and it says, and she will bring forth a son, and you shall call his name Jesus, for he shall save his people from their sins. Our text is taken from the book of Mark, chapter 5, verse 21 to 43. Now, Jesus was born for a reason. Yes, he was born for a reason. And he came to the world, like we can see from our memory verse, he came to the world to save us from our sins and the punishment for sin. Now you may ask, what is sin for our younger ones? Sin is disobedience to God's word. Sin is disobedience to God's word. So when God's word tells you something and you don't obey, that is sin. Now, Romans chapter 6, verse 23 tells us, for the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life in Christ Jesus our Lord. What does that mean? It means that every time we sin, every time we disobey God, the reward the devil has for everyone who disobeys God is death. Little by little, he wants ultimately for the person to die. Now, Jesus came to save us. He came to save you. He came to save me. He came to save the whole world from their sins and the punishment for the sin. And Jesus fulfilled, when Jesus was on earth, he fulfilled the purpose, the reason why he came to earth. He fulfilled that purpose. And even till today, Jesus is still saving people from sin and from death. Now we're going to go on to look at some of the works that Jesus did while he was here on earth. What were some of those things Jesus did? I know we've heard so many stories, but we're going to just focus on four. Now, first, in John chapter 2, verses 1 to 11, we see that Jesus was at a wedding in Cana, and the wine, they didn't have wine. They served the wine till it got finished, and they became worried. But Jesus told them that at the right time, he would speak the word. And at the right time, Jesus turned the water they had into wine. Yes. Another story, another interesting story, is found in the book of Mark chapter 5, verse 21 to 43. That's our text for today. Now, one of the stories there is about a man called Jairus. He had a little daughter, like some of you out there, young, and she was ill. And Jairus didn't stay there to start crying. Jairus rushed out, and when he found Jesus, he told Jesus, my child is dying, she's ill, but I know that if you come and you touch her, she'll be okay. And Jesus was following him. Now, in that story, when Jesus, by the time they got to the house, or close to the house, some people came to meet Jairus, don't bother Jesus anymore, your daughter is dead. Jesus heard it But he told Jairus, don't listen to them. Let's go. Let's go. And when they got to the house, they saw people crying and wailing. Oh, the little girl is dead. And Jesus said, why all the crying? The little girl is just sleeping. Do you know what they did? They started laughing. Imagine, the little girl is dead. You are saying she's sleeping. But Jesus made sure they all left the house. They went outside. And then he went into the room with Jairus, his wife, that's the little girl's mother, and three of his disciples. And Jesus raised Jairus' daughter from the dead. Jairus' daughter was came
Please
back to
break
life.
In to steal it.
Yes.
Store up treasure in heaven. For where your treasure is, there will your heart be also.
My name is Jairus. I am one of the elders of the synagogue here. My little daughter is dying. I beg you, come and lay your hands on her so that she may be cured and live.
Take me to her.
He's arriving. He's coming. He's bringing the van.
Master, your daughter is dead.
Do not weep. The child is not dead. Only sleeping.
Who are you to come here with your jokes? We've seen that she's dead. You haven't.
Peace, Thomas. Peace. Talitha Kumi. Rise, little girl. Something to eat.
She's alive! She's alive! She's alive!
Jesus did, and that is what he can still do today and forever. Now, in the book of Mark, chapter 10, verse 46 to 53, we see another interesting story. I'm sure some of you have heard of that story, Blind Bartimaeus. Blind Bartimaeus used to stay at the road by the roadside, begging for alms, people giving him money here and there. But one day, Jesus was passing by that way. And immediately blind Bartimaeus learned that it was Jesus. He started shouting, Jesus, Jesus, Son of David, have mercy on me. And do you know what happened? Jesus called blind Bartimaeus, called him, and by the time he got there, Jesus healed blind Bartimaeus, and blind Bartimaeus started seeing. Another interesting example in the Bible is Lazarus. I'm sure some of you too have heard of that story. Yes, Lazarus in the Bible. This time, Lazarus was not only dead, he had been buried for days. And then Jesus appeared. Hallelujah. And do you know what happened? Do you know? Jesus raised Lazarus back to life. Yes. So if we look at all these examples, it simply tells us one thing. Jesus did it in the past. He is more than able to do it today and forever. So what is that thing that is disturbing you? What is that problem? What is that challenge? Call on Jesus. When Jesus in the family, happy, happy home. Happy, happy home. Happy, happy home. When Jesus in the family, happy, happy home. Happy, happy home. When Jesus is in your boat, you cannot sink. So whatever the problem is today, call on Jesus and he will save you. Now, Jesus came to the world to save us from sin. He came to give us the life of God. And he came to give us back everything that the devil stole from us. So you have Jesus. But is there anybody out there who has made Jesus his or her friend? I want you to say after me. Lord Jesus, I thank you for your word today. Thank you for all the beautiful things that you have shown us about all that Jesus did and is still doing today. Lord, I haven't obeyed you. I have done those things that you said I shouldn't do. I have disobeyed you. But today, I want Jesus to come into my life as my friend. Jesus, please come into my life. Be my friend. Help me to obey God. Help me to do those things that please you. Everything, every bad thing I've been doing, today, I promise, I will no longer go back to them. I receive grace to live that life pleasing to God. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Amen. Congratulations, you're a friend of Jesus now. And make sure you continue to pray to God, you continue to read the word, you continue to hear his word like you're listening to me now. Good. So before we come to the end of today's teaching, I want us to play a little game. We've heard so much about what Jesus did in the past and what he can still do. So I will say something and then you will tell me who Jesus is in one word. When Jesus heals the sick, he is healer. Good. When he saves sinners, who is Jesus? Savior. He is Savior. He's our Savior. When he forgives sins, when he forgives our sins, who is he? Did I hear you say forgiver? Good. Very good. What about when he protects us? He is protector. Good. When he delivers us from evil, who is Jesus? Deliverer. Great. When he gives us food, shelter, clothing, who is he? Provider. Jehovah Jireh, provider. When he teaches us, when there's something difficult, we don't understand, and we call on him and he gives us wisdom. to know what exactly we are to do. Who is he when he teaches us? Teacher. Good. Good. Now we have come to the end of today's lesson. May God continue to bless and keep you. And remember, when we do those things that please God, we continue to have Jesus as our friend. Good. Till we come your way again next Sunday, stay safe, stay blessed. Bye-bye.